Welcome to Beer Goggles Reviews with me, Terry Kay. One out of my Kotze and Boffa box. My very safe and very well looked after Kotze and Boffa box. I think the weather's changing. I'm kind of starting to get warm again. I'm like a weather vane, me. I can tell when it's getting warmer. I start getting all like sweaty and greasy and whatever. It's lovely, isn't it? But getting on, we've got a 3.6 ABV, and this is called a Black Dog. This is another award-winning ale from Elgood's, from Cambridgeshire, and that's all I can really tell you about it. Apart from that, is the little chap on the standard there, on the kind of the what do they call that, the whatever, on the kind of shield and that, you know. And it would be some sort of guardian of some sort of key to some sort of castle or castile or whatever. Pardon me. Right, so let's crush it open. Being called Black Dog, I'm hoping it's going to be a stout, but I don't know. No, I say, it's a dark mild. Ooh, I like mild. I do, I like a mild. Right, let's go. Yeah, it's a funny thing, since I've kind of been losing weight, people have said I can see little spanglies coming off me every now and again. I just see one in the light. Might be flies, could be anything, you know. But then there's something, you know, there's ghosts in it. Derek Acor would love me, he'd be up behind me. Whoa, look at it. No, stop it. With the ghosts, I mean, and things, and waiting with his dark camera and stuff. Right, there is the lovely Plain Crown doing its job. Alright, not kind of pretty, but doing its job. But then we've got a nice pretty label, and that's doing its job as well. It's sniffed neck. Nothing hardly off the neck, just a little bit of edge of burnt toast, which is, for me, a good sign. Oh, I say, look at that. That's looking lovely. Right, nice collar on there. Nice colour collar. Oh, dark, dark, dark. But it is dark, 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 dark burgundy is what you're getting. I don't think we're going to actually get this. No, I don't think you're going to get it, not even through there at all. No, but let's try with my little torch if I can see him. There he is. Whoa. There, really bright through there. But you won't see that. That's because this is really bright. But you won't see it that bright up at the light. It's just got a very mild burgundy. Don't think you can actually get this if I... Just around the edges, sort of. Now, see, that's too bright. I'm going to have to get a more dull torch, I think. That's what I use for kind of seeing when I'm tasting, I'd look for. You know. But there you go. It's a little pocket one, you know. I've got a small one on the key ring, but it comes up a little bit of different colour. Anyway, let's have a twirl and a smell. A little bit disappointing on the nose, but a few of theirs have been disappointing on the nose. But I'm not bothered about the nose that much. I get more. The only time I've really loved the nose on the beer, very few times, but one, the main one was with the Harvey's, was it Harvey's? Yeah, Harvey's Imperial Extra Double Stout. That one, I kept the bottle and kept lifting it and sniffing. Oh, Jesus, that was unbelievable on the nose. And that was worth just keeping the bottle and sniffing for days afterwards, out of the dregs in the bottle and that, you know. But a little bit disappointing on the nose. You're getting not really much, kind of a tiny little bit of burnt toast. Little kind of very ripe cherries. A hint of chocolate in there. Kind of piney resins of some sort. But all kind of all bullied over with this big burnt toast. And all the others are very, very subdued and quiet. But, like I said, I ain't worried if it don't even talk to me at all on the nose. I really ain't. Because if it tastes nice, and I'm kind of thinking it might do. If it tastes nice, then that's all I'm worried about, really, honestly. So let's go in for the taste. Bottoms up, cheers, chin chin. Nostrovia. Let's go. Oh. Mmm. Now you're talking, now that's lovely. That's got a very weird and wonderful little spicy floral edge to it. You're getting a little hint of kind of a vanilla in there as well. Oh, that's nice. Mm, let's go in again. A big dirty edge of burnt toast and cocoa. Highly roasted cocoa. Oily, kind of a lot oily coating. Oh, that's lovely, really lovely. I like that. What's that other note you got in there as well? It doesn't seem 3.6, it seems to be kicking a bit heavier than that. Seems to be punching out of its weight in that, you know. So that's lovely. But there's a note in there I just can't get. What does it sound about? Malt flavoured, blah blah blah. It says malt and hops. It says very little. Doesn't really tell you a lot on the bottle. I wish they'd have a little ingredients list. I really do. You know, just and not the kind of malt, barley, water, and whatever. You know, because yeah, you know that can be almost any beer. But a nice little ingredient list. You know, if it's made of if it's made with a malt extract of some sort, say that. You know, don't say malt. You know. Pardon me. If it's made with a malt, say what sort of malts, you know, crystal malt, chocolate and whatever, you know, just say what malts are in there, you know, Maris Piper, I nearly said, Maris Piper, but, you know, just list the malts, list the hops, we ain't asking to know when they went in, you know, how long for and what temperatures and everything else, you know, which all make a very, very different brew and a beer, you know, but you know, just it would be nice if everyone put an ingredients list on, kind of, even if it was legislated or something like that. But anyway, I'm going on an old rant, which I should leave alone, really. One more little go. That's cute. It is cute. Again, it's nothing that you're going to kind of, it's going to punch you up the ear hole and whoa, like this, you know. But it's one of those sit down, just one of those sit down and relax beers. Now, I could sit and quaff that all night. I really could. And I could sit and quaff either any of these Elgood's beers. I really could. I could so enjoy them. Just sit, relax. If you're having a sit and relax, get a mixed case of Elgood's beers. If you're having a game of cards, mixed case for you and the boys. Just there's one for you. We'll all have one of these. Now, deal the cards out. bit later, yep, we'll all have a different one now, and all that business, you know, just try them all out. And, yeah, you'd be well satisfied, and also, they're not going to kind of be the star of the evening. They're not going to kind of overtake the conversation, whereas you end up, like, not playing cards and drinking beer instead, you know, which ain't a bad thing, but you know what I mean, you know. Anyway, cheers, bottoms up, here's to easy drinking, and here's to the guys at Elgood's, and here's to Jason, Cotsy and Boffa. Cheers all, bottoms up.